now as I'm sorry, now as you brothers and sisters, to acknowledge those working above amongst you, who care for you and the Lord and admonish you, hold them in the highest regard and love because of their works. Live in peace with one another. I'd like to just give kind of just a brief overview of each scripture. While I was studying, I found that verse 11 was the one that really resonated with me the most. It says, therefore, encourage one another and build up each other, just as in fact you are doing. The scripture is instructing us not to seek comfort, but to be the comforter and edify one another as Christians. God commands us not to build up, God commands us to build up the body of Christ, but also our spiritual leaders, such as our pastors and elders.
Amen. Amen.
In today's times, it seems like we magnify tearing down one another. The rooter you are, the cooler you are. We often see this in the reality shows that we see, such as Real Housewives of Atlanta or Basketball Wives, just to name a few. These shows are a continuous display of tearing down your brothers and sisters. Apostle Paul is telling us that God does not want us to engage in such acts. We fail to realize that the words we speak are powerful. Our words speak life and death into any situation. Proverbs 18:21 says, death and life are in the power of your tongue, and they who love it eats the fruits. Our Father wants his children to comfort and edify one another. Encouragement is like oxygen. We know that if we do not take in oxygen, we begin to suffocate. Right? This eventually leads to death. When we encourage one another, it gives us breath. It puts life in us, just as God did. When you encourage one another, you're acting like three people, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Proverbs 16 edifies this sentiment the most. It states, pleasant words as a honeycomb speak to the soul and help to the bones. Encouragement makes it easier to love as Jesus loved. Verse 12 states, now we ask, brothers and sisters, to acknowledge those who work hard among you, who care for you in the Lord and admonish you. This scripture is instructing us to acknowledge our spiritual leaders, for their works are great. God states three things about our leaders. They are hard workers, not just physically, but mentally as well. When we are sleeping, they are each praying for us. Two, God commands that they are to exercise their role and lead over his people. Hebrews 13:17 states, obey those who rule over you and be submissive, for they watch out for your souls as those who give account. Let them do so with joy, not with grief, for that would be unprofitable to you. Number three, they are to admonish you, meaning that they are to counsel us for improper conduct and warn and instruct us. Sometimes this concept seems unfair, but it is done gently and loving, just as our Heavenly Father So you see, brothers and sisters, this is the attribute of our pastor Moore. We need to remember to build him up because he is following God's command. This is necessary to ensure a strong body of believers. Lastly, verse 13, Apostle Paul is telling us that God wants us to live in peace with one another. We should not engage in conflict with one another, and we should not harbor ill feelings toward our leaders, for God frowns upon us. In closing, I want you to picture what I'm about to illustrate. Genesis 2:7 states, then the Lord God formed man from dust of ground. He breathed life into man's nostrils, and the man became a living person. Remember, just as God breathed life into